Hi, I'm Dhruv, a product manager on AWS Lambda, and today I'm excited to give you an overview of Lambda extensions. Extensions are a new way for you to easily integrate your favorite operational tools for monitoring, observability, security, and governance with Lambda. You can use extensions from AWS, AWS Partners, and open source projects. And as of this recording, there are extensions available for all of these tools. Head over to the link below where you can see the latest set of instructions and what you can achieve with them. Extensions help solve a common request from customers to make it easier to integrate their favorite operational tools with Lambda. Previously, customers told us that integrating some tools required extra operational and configuration tasks. In addition, tools such as log routers, which are long-running processes, could not easily run on Lambda. With Lambda extensions, you can plug in the tools you want to use directly into the Lambda environment without complex configuration or installation. You can use extensions for use cases such as capturing diagnostic information before, during, and after a function invocation, automatically instrumenting your code without needing to make code changes, fetching configuration settings or secrets before the function invocation, sending telemetry to custom destinations directly and asynchronously from Lambda functions, detecting and alerting on function activity through security agents. Getting started with extensions is easy. You can deploy extensions as layers and use environment variables to configure them. Or if you package and deploy your Lambda functions as container images, you can add the extension to your image. To get specific instructions, head over to the documentation provided by your favorite tooling vendor. Now, let's take a look at how Lambda extensions work and talk a little bit about Lambda's environment. Lambda provides a sandboxed environment, and this is where your function code runs. This isolates your function from other functions and provides the resources, such as memory, which you specify in the function configuration. The Lambda service initializes this environment on demand during the first invocation, or in advance of the first invocation if you use provisioned concurrency, which keeps functions initialized and ready to respond in double-digit milliseconds. When you invoke a Lambda function, the Lambda service routes the request to this environment. After your code has processed the request, the Lambda service freezes this environment. It thaws it later if it needs to reuse it for another invocation. When the function has not been used for some time, the Lambda service spins down this environment. In this way, the Lambda service automatically manages the lifecycle of compute resources. Let's zoom in a bit. The main process within the Lambda environment is the runtime, which runs your function code. The runtime process uses the runtime API to communicate with the Lambda service. It requests invocation events from the Lambda service and then invokes the function handler. After the function code is done, it returns the response to the runtime API and asks for the next invocation event. If there are no events ready to be processed, the Lambda service freezes the environment. Extensions are a new way for tools to more easily integrate deeply into the Lambda environment. They use the extensions API to request lifecycle events, process them, and then tell the Lambda service when they are done. Through this API, extensions get greater control of the lifecycle of the environment. The Lambda service freezes it once the runtime and all extensions are done. Let's take a closer look at how extensions can run during all phases of the Lambda lifecycle: initialization, invoke, and shutdown. First, extensions can run before the function because the Lambda service starts extensions before the runtime and the function. Second, during the invoke phase, extensions can run logic in parallel to the function and can also choose to run after the function code is done. Extensions can use this time for things like sending out data collected during the invoke. The Lambda service freezes the environment when the runtime and all extensions are done, and so in this way, extensions can influence the freeze and thaw behavior. Finally, extensions can run during a shutdown phase, which occurs before the environment is spun down. They can use this time for final cleanup tasks. Note, because extensions run in the same environment as the function code, they share resources such as memory, CPU, and credentials with the runtime process. Now, before we wrap up, let's talk a little bit about logs. To help you troubleshoot failures in a function, the Lambda service automatically captures logs generated by your function and streams them to CloudWatch. This log stream contains the logs which are generated from within your function code and also those that are generated by the Lambda service as part of the invoke. Extensions for tools like log routers can now use the logs API to subscribe to these log streams, and the Lambda service will then stream logs to the extension. Previously, third-party tools would get logs via CloudWatch, and now they can also use the logs API to get them directly from within the Lambda environment. So to wrap up, you can see that extensions are a new way to integrate tools with Lambda. Extensions can run in parallel with the function and can also continue to run after the function code is done. They use the extensions API to control and influence the lifecycle of the Lambda environment. In addition, the new logs API gives extension authors a simple interface to receive a stream of logs. These capabilities together make it even easier for you to use your favorite tools with AWS Lambda. For more information, take a look at the links below. Thank you.